ട്രാൻസ് ഈസോഫാജിയൽ എക്കോകാർഡിയോഗ്രാഫിക് വ്യൂസ്. അമേരിക്കൻ സൊസൈറ്റി ഓഫ് എക്കോകാർഡിയോഗ്രാഫി ഹാസ് ഡിസ്ക്രൈബ്ഡ് സെവറൽ സ്റ്റാൻഡേർഡ് വ്യൂസ് ഫോർ ട്രാൻസ് ഈസോഫാജിയൽ എക്കോകാർഡിയോഗ്രാഫി. ദ വ്യൂസ് ആർ ഒബ്ടെയിൻ ഫ്രം ദി അപ്പർ ആൻഡ് മിഡ് ഈസോഫാഗസ് ആസ് വെൽ ആസ് ഫ്രം ദ സ്റ്റമക് ട്രാൻസ് ഗാസ്ട്രിക് വ്യൂസ്. അപ്പർ ഈസോഫാജിയൽ വ്യൂസ്. These views are obtained with a probe about 20 to 25 centimeters from the incisors. Aortic arch long axis view is obtained with a probe in short axis plane 0 degrees. Even though the probe is in 0 degrees, the arch is visualized as an oblong structure which is the long axis of the arch. Left brachiocephalic vein can also be seen in this view. As the probe is withdrawn proximally, trachea comes in between and the view of the arch vessels is lost. Aortic arch short axis is obtained with the probe imaging plane at 90 degrees. Aortic arch, pulmonary artery, pulmonary valve and the left brachiocephalic vein are the structures which may be imaged in this view. Mid esophageal views are obtained at 30 to 40 centimeters from the incisors. Four chamber view is obtained with the probe at 0 to 20 degrees. The structures visualized are the left ventricle, left atrium, right ventricle, right atrium, mitral valve, tricuspid valve, and the interatrial and intraventricular septa. Mitral commissural view is obtained with the probe at 60 to 70 degrees. Mitral valve, left ventricle, and left atrium can be imaged in this view. Two-chamber view has the probe angle 80 to 100 degrees. The short form for this view is ME two-chamber. Left ventricle, left atrium, left atrial appendage, mitral valve and coronary sinus can be seen in this view. Long axis view is imaged at 120 to 160 degrees and the short form is ME LAX. Left ventricle, left atrium, aortic valve, left ventricular outflow tract, mitral valve and ascending aorta can be visualized in this view. This is a suboptimal view as the ventricle is obliquely seen and the aortic valve is not seen well. RV inflow outflow view is imaged at 60 to 90 degrees which shows the right ventricle, right atrium, tricuspid valve, right ventricular outflow tract, pulmonary valve and pulmonary artery. AV short axis view is obtained with the probe angle at 30 to 60 degrees. The short form for this view is MEAVSAX. It can visualize the aortic valve, intraatrial septum, coronary ostia, left ventricular outflow tract and the pulmonary valve. The unmistakable landmark in this view is the aortic valve seen in cross-section like a Mercedes-Benz sign. AV long axis view has the probe angle at 120 to 160 degrees. The view is known in short form as MEAVLAX. Aortic valve, left ventricular outflow tract, proximal ascending aorta and right pulmonary artery are seen in this view. Bicaval view is obtained with the probe angle at 80 to 110 degrees. This is a long axis view of the atrial septum and superior vena cava. In addition, the right atrium, left atrium, inferior vena cava and a section of the right pulmonary artery can be visualized. Ascending aortic short axis view has the probe angle at 0 to 60 degrees. Short form of the view is MES aortic SAX. It can image the superior vena cava, main pulmonary artery and right pulmonary artery in addition. The left main bronchus interferes with the imaging of the left pulmonary artery, which cannot be visualized. Ascending aortic long axis view is obtained with the probe angle at 100 to 150 degrees. The view is known in short as MES aortic LAX. This view also visualizes the right pulmonary artery. Descending aorta short axis view has the probe angle at 0 degrees. The short form of the view is DIS aorta SAX. The view images the descending thoracic aorta. Descending aorta long axis view is seen with probe angle 90 degrees to 110 degrees. The view is known in short as DIS aorta LAX and visualizes the descending thoracic aorta. Transgastric views are obtained with probe at 40 to 45 centimeters from the incisors. Basal short axis view, imaged at 0 to 20 degrees probe angle, is also known as TG basal SAX. The view images the left ventricle, mitral valve, right ventricle, and the tricuspid valve. The anterior mitral leaflet, left ventricular outflow tract, and the mitral orifice are seen in this view. Mid-short axis view obtained with probe angle 0 to 20 degrees is known in short as TG mid-SAX. The left ventricle is seen in cross-section along with the interventricular septum, right ventricle, and the papillary muscles. The inferior, posterior, and anterior walls of the left ventricle are seen in this view. To obtain this view, after the probe is passed beyond the gastroesophageal junction, slight antiflexion of the probe is needed to get mucosal contact. Two-chamber view is imaged with 80 to 100 degrees probe angle. The view is also known as TG two-chamber. The anterior mitral leaflet is seen well in this view also. Other structures imaged are the left ventricle, caudate tendine, papillary muscle, coronary sinus, and the left atrium. Long axis view has the probe angle at 90 to 120 degrees. It is also termed the TG-LAX view. It visualizes the anterior mitral leaflet with adjacent left ventricular outflow tract and aortic valve. RV inflow view is obtained with a probe angle of 100 to 120 degrees and images the right ventricle, tricuspid valve, right atrium, caudae, and papillary muscles of the tricuspid valve. Deep transgastric views are obtained with probe at 45 to 50 centimeters from the incisor teeth. Long axis view is imaged with the probe angle at 0 to 20 degrees with antiflexion. This view images the left ventricular outflow tract, aortic valve, ascending aorta, and the arch. Obtaining the view is a little uncomfortable for the awake patient. The view is known in short as deep TG-LAX. If you like this video, please like it and share it. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.